To start today's episode, these are the 5 wonder tips for you to remember to keep your back, neck, and eyes healthy while indulging in some screen time. This is Teacher Melvin's Healthy Tips for Everyone. Number 1. Sit properly so you are well supported. Your back should be touching the chair backrest. Number 2. Change your position regularly. If you are watching for long periods, take turns sitting on the couch, chair, or floor. Number 3. Keep dim lighting on in the room rather than no lighting. Strong or no lighting may lead to eye damage over time. Number 4. Stretch. Use commercial breaks to change positions, to get up and walk around, and to do gentle stretches. Number 5. Don't watch TV in bed, as this often leads to neck and back ache. There, you are now ready to begin. Wonder Warriors, it's me, Teacher Melvin, your companion to your wonder science adventures. Learn everything under the sun, because here at DepEd TV, Grade 10 Science is fun. So buckle up and get ready to power your mind. This is Wonder Science. What's up, Wonder Warriors? I hope everyone is doing well and staying safe. Always remember that we are in this together. And keeping the Filipino spirit, kaya natin ito, mga ka-wonder. And congratulations, you have successfully completed Module 4. As a prize, I will give you another Wonder Trophy. Last episode, you learned about mantle convection and forces as a mechanism to the motion of the massive plates of the lithosphere and the development of the theory of plate tectonic. Remember, the plate tectonic theory states that the Earth's lithosphere, the crust, and the upper mantle is broken up into several pieces called plates that move slowly. It explains how the massive plates move along the different types of plate boundaries, convergent, divergent, and transform fault, where they interact and geologic events such as earthquakes and subduction occur, and geologic features such as formation of mountains, volcanoes, and trenches that occur at their boundaries. As a recap, to which can we attribute the movement of the lithospheric plate? Take note, the movement of the lithospheric plate is attributed to the mantle convection and considered as one of the driving mechanisms for plate motion. The lithosphere at the divergent boundary will uplift and tear apart due to the rising of hot magma. The sinking of magma pulls down the tectonic plate at the convergent boundary. Aside from mantle convection, what are other forces that move the lithospheric plates? The other forces that move the lithospheric plates include ridge push, sliding, and slab pull. There! I'm happy to know that you're able to remember what we explored about Earth's mechanism. For today's lesson, kindly refer to your self-learning module. Let's explore and learn together Module 5 titled Evidences of Plate Movements. Remember, lithospheric plates or the solid part of the Earth are gradually moving to form different geologic events such as earthquakes, mountain buildings, and volcanoes. But what causes these plates to move? What is the evidence that the Earth's plates are moving? These questions ignited our scientists' curiosity to look for answers and lead to the development of the following ideas: continental drift theory, seafloor spreading, and the Earth's magnetic reversal. But before that, let's have a short activity to check your prior knowledge about the evidences of plate movements. You will need to prepare the following materials: pencil and a piece of paper. I will read the question and choices once. You'll be given 5 seconds to choose and write your answer. For every correct answer, you'll be given a Wonder Coin. If you collect all 5, a Wonder Badge will be given to you. Are you now ready? Let's begin! Question 1. Which of the following evidences that scientists use to support the continental drift theory? A. Rocks, fossils, air. B. Rocks, water, ice. C. Rocks, fossils, climate. Or D. Rocks, fossils, human beings. The correct answer is letter C. Rocks, fossils, climate. Question 2. What discovery provided strong support for continental drift theory? A. Geology. B. Fossil evidence. C. Electromagnetism. Or D. Paleomagnetism. The correct answer is letter B. Fossil evidence. Question 3. Which is not an evidence of seafloor spreading? A. Molten magma constantly erupting. B. Drilling samples of rock. C. Fossil evidence. Or D. Magnetic stripes. The correct answer is letter C. Fossil evidence. Question 4. The magnets point north when Earth's magnetic field has A. Magnetic reversal. B. Reversed polarity. C. Mid-ocean ridge. Or D. Normal polarity. The correct answer is letter D. Normal polarity. Question 5. What do you call the process that forms and moves the new oceanic crust? A. Magnetic reversal. B. Seafloor spreading. C. Convection. D. Trenching. The correct answer is letter B. Seafloor spreading. How many Wonder Coins have you collected? Wonder Warriors, you did well in our preliminary activity. Keep up the good work. You have learned so far that Earth has distinct mechanical and compositional layers. This knowledge about the Earth's internal structure came from the indirect observation of our scientists through seismic activities. Scientists learned that as continental and oceanic crusts move, they can form geologic events such as earthquakes, volcanoes, and mountain ranges. Have you seen a world map before? Definitely yes, you have seen one. Take a look at this one. What can you say about the eastern border of South America and the western part of Africa? You have probably noticed that the eastern border of South America and the western part of Africa seem to fit together like a big jigsaw puzzle. If you're thinking the same answer, then you are thinking like Alfred Wegener, who was a German polar researcher, geophysicist, and meteorologist. He is remembered as the originator of the continental drift theory by hypothesizing in 1912 that the continents are slowly drifting around the Earth and is once a large landmass called Pangaea, a Greek word which means all Earth. Take a look at these figures. What do you see? These figures show the evolution of the supercontinent Pangaea to the present-day distribution of continents. Can you say the continents are drifting? Wegener's curiosity about the idea of drifting continents started when he noticed the edges of South America and Africa in a world map could be fitted like a jigsaw puzzle. To better understand this, let's explore the evidence that Alfred Wegener gathered. What do you see? This shows similar rock assemblages across different continents. Alfred Wegener collected diverse pieces of evidence to support his theory, including geological fit and fossil evidence. It is important to know that the following specific fossil evidence was not brought up by Wegener to support his theory. Wegener did not collect the fossils, but he called attention to the idea of using these scientific documents, stating there were fossils of species present in separate continents in order to support his claim. Geological fit evidence is the matching of large-scale geological features on different continents. It has been noted that the coastlines of South America and West Africa seem to match up. However, more particularly, the rock terrains of separate continents confirm as well. Examples include the Appalachian Mountains of eastern North America, linked with the Scottish Highlands, and the familiar rock of strata of the Karoo system of South Africa, matched correctly with the Santa Catarina system in Brazil, and Brazil and Ghana mountain ranges agreeing over the Atlantic Ocean. Glaciers carve rocks and leave marks as they move. In this evidence, scientists can determine the direction of movement of each continent. In addition, the existence of coal deposits in Antarctica suggested that it has once located near in the region of the Earth where the climate is enough to support complex life forms such as plants and tall trees. Focus your attention to this figure. Can you notice the direction of the movements of the continents? The direction of the movement of the continents is indicated by the arrows during Pangaea time. This time, look at this map. What does it show? It shows how Alfred Wegener mapped out the distribution of the four Permian and Triassic fossil groups and used it as biogeographic evidence for continental drift and land bridging. Wonder Warriors, how are you so far? Don't forget to take note of the important details on a piece of paper. Remember, by taking notes, you can easily remember our lessons. Got it? Very good! Let's proceed! And now, I would like you to focus your attention to these four illustrations. Can you name these organisms? Did you know that they are considered evidence of the movement of the continents? Let's get to know them one by one. Let's have the first illustration. This is a modern-day representation of the Mesosaurus. Did you know that the Mesosaurus is known to have been a type of reptile, similar to the modern crocodile? Mesosaurus, like the modern ones, propelled itself through the water with its long hind legs and limber tail. It lived during the early Permian period, that's around 286 to 258 million years ago, and its remains are found solely in South Africa and eastern South America. Now, if the continents were still in their present positions, there is no possibility that the Mesosaurus would have the capability to swim across such a large body of ocean like the Atlantic because it was a coastal animal. How about the second illustration? Can you name this mammal-like reptile? This is a modern-day representation of the Cynognathus. The now extinct Cynognathus was a mammal-like reptile, roaming the terrains during the Triassic period, that's around 250 to 240 million years ago. The Cynognathus was as large as a modern wolf. Its fossils are found only in South Africa and South America. As a dominant land species, the Cynognathus would not have been capable of migrating across the Atlantic. Let's have the third one. This is the modern-day representation of the Lystrosaurus. The Lystrosaurus, which translates to shovel reptile, is thought to have been a herbivore with a snout built like a pig. Lystrosaurus fossils are only found in Antarctica, India, and South Africa. Similar to the land-dwelling Cynognathus, the Lystrosaurus would not have had the swimming capability to traverse any ocean. And finally, the modern-day representation of Glossopteris. Possibly the most important fossil evidence found in the plant is Glossopteris. The Glossopteris fossil is found in Australia, Antarctica, India, South Africa, and South America, all the southern continents. The Socterus seed is known to be large and bulky and possibly couldn't have drifted or flown across the oceans to a separate continent. Therefore, the continents must have been joined at least one point in time in order to maintain the Glossopteris wide range across the southern continents. To wrap it up, this illustration will show you the fossil locations of the Mesosaurus, Cygnonatus, Lystrosaurus, and Glossopteris spread across different continents. So there, you have just learned that Alfred Wegener's curiosity drives him to look for evidence that supports his continental drift theory that continents were once connected as a big landmass called Pangaea. The continental drift theory is being supported by the following evidence: continental fit, matching of rocks, fossils of ancient organisms, coal deposits in Antarctica, ancient climates, and glaciers carvings. And now, challenge yourself to do this 5-item quiz. I will read the question and choices once. You're only given 5 seconds to write the letter of the correct answer for each question. You will be given 1 gold coin for every correct answer. Are you ready? Wonder Warriors, let's play Science Pop Quiz. Question 1. He was credited for the idea of continental drift theory. A. Alfred Wegener. B. Charles Darwin. C. Harry Hammond Hess. D. Robert Deitz. The correct answer is letter A, Alfred Wegener. Question 2. All continents were once joined together, forming a supercontinent called A. Panthalassa, B. Laurasia, C. Gondwanaland, D. Pangaea. The correct answer is letter D, Pangaea. Question 3. It is possibly the most important fossil plant evidence that continents are drifting. A. Glossopteris, B. Lystrosaurus, C. Mesosaurus, D. Cygnonatus. The correct answer is letter A, Glossopteris. Question 4. Which of the following shows the evidence gathered by Alfred Wegener to support his continental drift theory? A. Continental fit, rocks, fossils, coal deposits. B. The ancient climate of Antarctica and Africa. C. Remains of dead plants and animals. D. Observing the map. The correct answer is letter A, continental fit, rocks, fossils, coal deposits. Question 5. What two specific continents fit together most noticeably? A. Africa and North America. B. South America and Africa. C. South America and Europe. D. Antarctica and Africa. The correct answer is letter B, South America and Africa. Well done, Wonder Warriors! I am happy that you were able to challenge yourself to do the pop quiz. Now, let us add all the gold coins you've collected from the pop quiz. How many gold coins have you collected? For all the effort that you do, I will give you a fantastic badge. Katanungan sa ating isip ay may kasagutan. Para magpupol sa akal ay makakanta. Wonder Science, ang ating kagabay. Alam o siyensya, kadugtong ng ating buhay.
Agham! Siyensya! Halina't mag-aral na siyensya.
Always remember, science is fun for everyone. This has been your Wonder Explorer, Teacher Melvin. See you next time for another episode of Fun Wonder Adventures. Only here at DEPA TV.